Family Portrait in Black and White, after it went to Sundance and then won Best Canadian Feature at Hot Dogs, is going to many festivals. In the fall, we will just start our European festivals tour. So we don't know whether we will win anything there. But it's going very well in terms of the number of the festivals and the way it is received by the audience everywhere. The funny thing is that the woman in our film, she is a complex person. So depending on the values in each particular country, the reaction of the audience, how they see her, is different. In some countries, she is considered like really a saint because she's doing so much good things for her children. And in some countries, she is considered like domineering nightmare because she is shaping the life of the children the way she wants, despite their desires. So it's interesting to see that. But so far, so good. When I came across an article about a woman who was raising 16 mixed-race teenagers that were abandoned at the orphanage at birth, I wanted to make this film. I contacted her. She was in Ukraine. And we made a film together with her and with the children. And I went there 3 years, 3 summers. When I learned about a woman who is raising on her own 16 mixed-race children in a country that is racist, of course, I thought she is like Mother Teresa. And then when I started to film, I noticed that she actually can love unconditionally the children that are weaker than she is, that have some limitations, that need her, immensely need her. But the children that are stronger or more gifted than she is, she had difficult time accepting that they have their own idea about their life. And of course, the same thing happens with us, with the parents, and then with our relations with our children, because it takes time to accept that your child might be right and you might be wrong. Or even if your child is not right today, maybe in the long run, the child knows what is right for him or her. So Olga had a problem with that. And sometimes this problem went to the extreme. And that was the thing that I wasn't expecting, and it is in the film. The fact that I had a teenage daughter and was a mother that had clashes with the daughter and that was grieving that the daughter is getting older and leaving me, it was very important. I think that if the director was a man, he would be way more harsh on the foster mother because he wouldn't forgive her for certain shortcomings, because he wouldn't be able to project it on him as a mother, of course. And I was able, so I think it was very important that I was a woman. And that's why I think I didn't make the film that I thought I would make, and it's great that the real events guided it in a different direction. I think that in Canada, actually, women are more aware of their abilities and of their powers to become film directors. In Eastern Europe, there are much fewer film directors that are women. And in terms of talent, I think there is no difference between men and women.